The continually expanding economic shadow of the coronavirus reached around the globe this week.
What we are wrestling with is uncertainty, and that defines our projections, which at this point lead us to state that global growth in 2020 will dip, below its last year's levels.
2020 global GDP growth is estimated to hit 3%. The United States saw 2.3% growth for all of 2019.
What we know from experiencing similar crises is that about one-third of the economic losses from the disease will be direct costs from loss of life, workplace closures, and quarantines. The remaining two-thirds will be indirect, reflecting a retrenchment in consumer and business behavior and a tightening in financial markets. In other words, the impact of uncertainty.
Economic retrenchment can be seen in parts of China as residents shelter at home to avoid the virus, which first appeared in late December. The fear of public spaces has slowed factory production in the country, which is now rippling outwards into countries that depend on low-cost Asian labor for economic advantage.
Zenni's manufacturing model is completely reliant on Chinese production, and so any slowdown or work stoppages there affect our ability to deliver on time to our consumers.
West Coast ports are also seeing a slowdown in container traffic.
For the month of February, we're projecting that we will sustain another 6% decline year over year. We attribute all those declines to the coronavirus situation that's emanating in China.
Airlines around the world are reducing scheduled flights in response to a drop in travelers and have canceled trips on routes to areas with high rates of infection. As of Friday morning, the CDC is reporting 99 confirmed cases of coronavirus in the U.S., with 10 deaths. The slowing Chinese economy has raised doubts that the $40 billion in agricultural trade promised in the recent Phase 1 agreement will be purchased. Secretary of Agriculture Sonny Perdue tamped down questions of another round of market facilitation payments.
I'm telling farmers to do what they've always done and part plant for the market. I'm telling farmers that if we get the export, we get the trade, and we don't see prices increase, then market facilitation program was not a price support program. It was a trade disruption program, not price support. So if we see trade increase and prices don't go up, that's a market signal to farmers that we're producing too much.
From Market to Market, I'm Peter Tubbs.